What is it?
Patrick.
Yes, Jean.
There's a Mr. Donald Kimball here to see you.
Who?
Detective Donald Kimball.
Tell him I'm at lunch.
Patrick, it's only 10:30. I think he knows you're here.
Send him in, I guess. Now, John, you've got to wear clothes in proportion to your physique. There are definite do's and don'ts, good buddy, of wearing a bold striped shirt. A bold striped shirt calls for solid colored or discreetly patterned suits and ties. Yes, always tip the stylist 15%. Listen, John, I've got to go. T. Boone Pickens just walked in. Just joking. No, don't tip the owner of the salon. Okay, John, right? Got it. Sorry about that.
No, I'm sorry. I should have made an appointment. Was that anything important?
All that? Just mulling over business problems, examining opportunities, exchanging rumors, spreading gossip.
Hi. I'm Donald Kimball.
Hi, Pat Bateman. Nice to meet you.
Sorry to barge in on you like this. I know how busy you guys can get.
So, what's the topic of discussion?
I've been hired by Meredith Powell
to investigate the disappearance of Paul Allen.
I see, yeah. Paul's disappearance, yeah.
Sir, it's nothing that official. I just have some basic questions about Paul Allen, about yourself.
Coffee?
No, I'm okay.
Paul and ours?
No, I'm okay.
Can you bring Mr.
Kimball.
Mr. Kimball, a bottle of
Apollo. No, really, I'm okay.
It's no problem. So, what's the topic of discussion?
The disappearance of Paul Allen.
Right. Well, I haven't heard anything about the disappearance or anything, not on page six at least.
I think his family wants this kept quiet.
Understandable. Lime?
Not really, I'm okay.
You sure? I can always get you a lime.
Just some preliminary questions that I need for my own files, okay?
Shoot.
How old are you?
27.
Where did you go to school?
Harvard, then Harvard Business School.
Your address?
American Gardens Building, West 81st Street.
Nice, very nice.
Thanks.
What can you tell me about Paul Allen?
I'm at a loss. He was part of that whole Yale thing.
Yale thing?
Yeah, Yale thing.
What do you mean, Yale thing?
Well, I think, for one, that he was probably a closet homosexual who did a lot of cocaine at Yale thing.
What kind of man was he, besides the information you've just given?
I hope I'm not being cross-examined here.
You feel like that?
No, not really.
Where did Paul hang out?
Hang out?
Yeah, you know, hang out.
Let me think. The Newport, Harry's, Flutie's, Indochine, Nell's, the Cornell Club, the New York Yacht Club.
He had a yacht?
No, he just hung out there.
And where did he go to school?
Don't you know this?
I just wanted to know if you know.
For Yale, if I remember correctly, St. Paul's. Listen, I just want to help.
I understand.
Do you have any witnesses or fingerprints?
Well, there's a message on his answering machine that says he went to London.
Maybe he did, huh?
His girlfriend doesn't think so.
But has anyone seen him in London?
Actually, yes. But I've had a hard time getting actual verification. A Stephen Hughes said he saw him at a restaurant there, but I checked it out, and what happened is he mistook a Herbert Ainsworth for Paul, so.
Had his apartment been burglarized?
No, actually, it hadn't. Toiletries were missing, a suit was gone, so was some luggage, that's it.
I mean, no one's dealing with the homicide squad yet or anything, right?
No, not yet. As I said, we're not sure. Basically, no one's seen or heard anything.
So typical, isn't it?
It's just strange. One day someone's walking around, going to work, alive, and then
nothing.
People just disappear.
The earth just opens up and swallows them.
Eerie. Really eerie.
Listen,
You'll have to excuse me. I have a lunch meeting with Cliff Huxtable at Four Seasons in 20 minutes.
The Four Seasons? Isn't that a little far uptown? I mean, aren't you going to be late?
No, there's one down here.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
It's very good.
Listen, if anything else occurs to you, any information at all?
Absolutely. I'm 100% with you.
Great. And thanks for your time, Mr. Bateman.